This is Dan Jennings, a 6'9", 245-pound center.
Watch. Now. The Dan Jennings Career Recap.
There is Michael Caffey coming out of the backcourt. Seventh best scorer in the conference, averaging 16 points, 5 rebounds, and also 4 assists. And now Hawaii showing some zone. Spencer off the wing with a flat three-pointer. And look at down inside. Dan Jennings going to work.
And that's just pure power. I mean, you can teach rebounding, but you can't teach heart, and you can't teach hustle going after the ball. He pursued this ball, snatched it away, tipped it to himself, and went back up really strong. I mean, just brute strength of him. Got to be one of the strongest players in the Big West, maybe with the exception of Alan Williams at Santa Barbara.
And I'll tell you, in looking at Dan Jennings, and we've seen him the last couple of seasons again after transferring from West Virginia, he looks to be in much better shape. Maybe lost 10 or 12 or 15 pounds. That
very awkward state of stage in this man-to-man defense right now. And they have to contain people off the bounce.
Two in a row off the bench. Yes, indeed. He said he didn't understand the terminology. So this young man, Travis Hammonds, really understands the game of basketball. He's down inside, number 24.
Oh, that ball spiked out of bounds.
And look at that. Oh, Dan Jennings.
He almost dunked that so hard it bounced out.
What a play at both ends. Designed to hopefully protect a guy that's in foul trouble as well, too.
And Fulton's a nice-looking player. Looks like he's in better shape than last year.
Look at that. Defensive breakdowns. Maybe it's better offense. Jennings right to the front of the round.
And they are playing very well tonight.
Nevels kick out to Stan Harden. 17-footer, no. Fotu battling for the rebound. Jennings has got it. So Jennings and Stan Hardiger, at least it looks like, will get to the second half with only those two personal fouls.
And the gamble by both coaches has paid off.
Nevels averages 14.5 points per game. That's his first basket. Jennings turning one way and back over the other shoulder. And Dan Jennings now has 9.
I like his post moves. You know, as the turnover leads to a fast break opportunity for Long Beach State.
Around to Dan Jennings there again.
You know, he's a workhorse. You talk about Christian Stan Hardinger for the University of Hawaii. Dan Jennings does the same for Long Beach State. I mean, he ran the floor hard, timed that ball just right, and got the one-handed slam.
Kick out to Caffey. Speaking of quiet first half, Caffey's with 1 of 4. That was a three-point make. Offensive rebound taken by Jennings once again, who now has 3 personal fouls. So Jennings got to be very careful at both ends. Good kick out to Lamb.
Three-pointer right in front of him. It's the Iron Man.
Wow.
I was very fortunate.
No wonder you're so pretty.
I don't know about that, but I'll take that call.
He's got to just be aggressive. You know, bat that ball out of the air. Spencer down inside, looking to Jennings, lays it up with the right hand.
You know, he never gets credit for it. He's
got to get something going to the basket. Fotu with 4 personal fouls. Good pass inside to Jennings, and he misses the layup. Jennings with a tip. Jennings with a tip again. Remember that possession. Perfectly designed by Long Beach State, and Jennings couldn't finish. Maybe the only mistake he made all night.
Well, just coming out of that, you know, timeout, I thought they did a great job of just getting the ball to him. He kind of short-armed it a little bit. Then all of a sudden it became a game of ping pong, where fortunately Long Beach State will retain
possession.
Difficulty getting it in. Spearman yet to score in the second half against the shot clock. Rebound taken by Jennings. Boy, does he mean business. 5 of 6 from the free throw line. 1:43 remaining off the front of the iron. And the lead now for Hawaii is just 3 at 61-58.
I like the play previously that Long Beach State ran. You just can't bounce past the ball into the post. Hawaii's still staying in that 2-3 zone defense. They're double daring you to try to get in the seams with your Long Beach State, as Michael Tapper does.
Happy on the floater, battle for the rebound. Look inside. Who's going? Oh, he missed it. Travis Hammonds missed it inside, and Long Beach will stay with it once again. Jennings now with 15. How big was that? Making up for a layup he missed about 6 minutes ago.
But Paul, I always say luck favors.
Deep into the shot clock, and now Long Beach State wants to run it up the floor, and they will get the basket. Ahead of the field is Dan Jennings.
Gives them another opportunity to score.
Averages 11 points and 7 rebounds per game, but this one taken down by Long Beach State, and it appears that Desmond Lee reached in and committed the foul. 22 wins as the head coach at Long Beach State.
I love that little tidbit. A lot of people forget that Tark was there at Long Beach.
49ers have made their last 3 shots in a row, and you'll make it 4 with a turnaround from Dan Jennings asserting himself inside.
Dan Jennings, you talked about him right when we tipped this game off. He's a big body presence in there. He's a shot blocker on the defensive end, but he can create space with his wide body on the offensive end.
Great look inside and the conversion by Leonard Freeman.
What a nice, pleasant surprise this young man has been. He is still 17 years old. He's a baby.
Coming off a double-double against Northwestern, and right back at you, it's Dan Jennings with a high arcing shot.
I love this. I love the battle of the paint inside. Make the
big... In the late 40s in those championship teams of every case.
Very impressive.
He was the first coach to ever cut down the nets after a championship. Wow. That's where that tradition comes from.
I love this. The tidbits that just come from you.
Washington has picked up his second foul of the case. His name and a whistle hanging from the rafters here at PNC Arena. Part of the rich tradition of basketball here at NC State. Twice national champions in 74, and who could ever forget 1983 and Jimmy Valvano. Vandenberg with the block. He had another one, but there was a whistle.
But you know what? No matter if there was a foul called there or not, he is making Long Beach State think twice about attacking that rim.
Tyler Lewis picked up the foul step.
Right there, that was quite an easy block. He got it on the way up. And then this one is the one the fans inside, they're not too happy about.
So Jennings is at the free throw line. Substitution is David Samuels comes in. Jennings, who shoots only 39%.
The zone is effective for Long Beach State because North Carolina State, they're not making the mark.
Jennings trying to wrestle it away from Vandenberg. Held the situation, and the possession arrow is going to favor the Wolfpack. In the early going this season. Jennings against 2 defenders.
They're used to winning. They play those tough schedules to get ready for their conference play. Their record is probably not an indicator of how good they are.
Yeah, this program has made the championship game of the Big West Tournament 3 of the last 4 years, and they won it in 2012. Carolina State started the game 3 of 9 from the floor, but since then, 7 of 11. We're all tied at 25.
Long Beach State still sitting in that zone.
Kind of a half shot, half attempt.
The defense in, making them defend the ball, leaving the shooter wide open.
Four in the miss. Pulled down by...
knows how to put the ball through the hoop, too. They've got a couple of scorers on this North Carolina State team that could really go off.
Kat Barber's a freshman from Hampton, Virginia. Broke all the high school scoring records of Allen Iverson. Not too bad.
That tells you something.
How about Jennings, the way he's playing this afternoon, Steph? He's now got 12.
He is very strong inside. He's methodical. His footwork is excellent. He does not...
Shots in the first half from Vandenberg. DJ Warren lost the handle. This is Caffey. I'll tell you what.
He controlled the offense without giving your opponent extra possessions. He has a history of averaging almost nearly as many turnovers as he does assists.
And he's got the ball now for Long Beach State. Look at the speed of Caffey.
Keep going to the rim until somebody stops you, and they'll do the same on the other end.
Dan Jennings going on a rim bender, and he's got 14 points. November 30th of this year in Washington with 11. Out of the corner, LaSalle. Samuels over the top. Jennings couldn't follow. Out of bounds, officials confirm. Spencer, three. And that was Jennings on the glass. And look at the reaction and the emotion from Dan Jennings.
That defensive stance, North Carolina State looked like they were not prepared. A little miscommunication. The shooter was wide.
Caffey. Jones. Jennings the tip. Hung on the rim. 17 in the second half for TJ Warren. That'll be Jennings. He's up to 18 points in the game.
As you look at Dan Jennings, open with the win over Hawaii Pacific, then a road loss at number 6 Arizona.
From the free throw line in his freshman season. As you look at Jennings, started his career with Bob Huggins at West Virginia, now in his third year
for K-State. Southwell, not this time. Jennings is there with the board. He averages 12 rebounds a game to go along with 15 points.
The Wildcats looked like they had numbers, but settled for a three.
Well, and the great thing about Gibson being here is now DJ Johnson doesn't have to play 36 minutes like he did in the opening loss to Northern Colorado.
With interior passing, Samuels can't finish, but Jennings does just to beat the shot clock, and he's on the board with his first two.
Well, there you saw the monster offensive rebound and putback, and he is so athletic. K-State's got to try to keep him off the boards. An impressive player.
And now Will all alone. No.
Murray State is not in this game right now, but they should be 4 points further behind after the last two opportunities the Cats had.
Jennings into a double team, and the tie-up will stay at this end. Long Beach having all sorts of trouble with K-State's defense.
Yeah, a lot of help. K-State getting their hands on the ball, and two different defenders are in there with their hands on the ball with Dan Jennings, and it's a tie-up.
Zone they're trying to match up. They don't want two guys with the basketball.
Just inside the arc. Shane leaves it short this time and rebounded by Jennings.
City, Texas hasn't been real productive in his career. Now a junior as DJ misses badly on the free throw.
Who's going to pick up the scoring for Mike Caffey? Well, you knew LaSalle wasn't going to shoot that because he didn't shoot two-pointers. But a nice dump-down feed, and the layup is good from Jennings.
Well, good offense right now is just getting the ball up off the rim and hope that Dan Jennings is there. That time with his left hand, he tips it back.
Jones had it blocked by a 1-2. Jennings got it back, splits two defenders, and gets it to kiss home.
You've got to be aware of where Jennings is all the time when he's on offense. The guy loves to lurk around the rim and get offensive rebound in the first half.
Half
McAfee behind the back. Good feed to Jennings. That might be the best offensive play of the game for the 49ers. And rebounded by Michaela Sal. Lead pass, Jennings. Oh, wow. Great hustle by the big guy. Beating everybody down court. Four triples to match the four he had last game against Oral Roberts. Jennings. Yes. Jennings has three straight buckets for Long Beach State.
I'm surprised he could get that second one in. He had to be dizzy spinning and rebounding and trying to score and spinning.
Jennings at one end, but Foster at the other. K-State with numbers. Foster looking for another three. And rebounded by Long Beach State.
May not be what Bruce Weber wants.
Jennings having a big second half.
And that is what Dan Munson wants. What a warrior. Double-double for the third of his four games this year. For a couple hours. Because the rest of the university is still working.
It's
and so are they.
It's a business trip, right?
Altman's going to have Oregon ready to go. Oregon, UCLA, and, of course, Arizona, the three best teams in the conference going in. Colorado's going to be very good as well. Start playing the second half. That was Jennings' first look for the Niners. Is that Spencer again inside? AJ Spencer.
That's something, he instilled that in Nigel. He wanted him to be a player that knew how to play the basketball game the right way.
It's not just him on this team. Washington actually has the best assist-to-turnover ratio in the Pac-12. 41-41. Jokic with the rebound. They want to go in transition. Here comes Mike Caffey. Oh, beautiful feed to Jennings. Looked off the defense, and everybody left Jennings alone.
Very simple look-away pass. It got C.J. Wilcox to bite. Wilcox knows better in defensive transition. You have to protect the paint first and then clear out to the perimeter.
Read and react by the big guy Jennings, all 6'9 from Staten Island. He ends up on the Washington bench. Oh, you got to love when your center's denying the lead, but here he is offensively, and it comes from Caffey.
Look at this look-away. He gets C.J. Wilcox to just bite. Bounced it right in there.
It's beautiful. Bounce pass to the big man. Leads him into the basket. Long Beach by two. Starting to get excited down in Southern California.
This one's going to go down to the wire. I think it's very clear that this is a competitive game. Both teams have the athletes to match up with each other. There goes Williams-Goss using that strength to kind of walk into the paint. Nice finish with the little one-handed floater.
Caffey again to Jennings. And Jennings again is uncontested inside.
And as the point guard, Andrew Andrews knew, Mike Anderson, whoever had the basketball, knew that the defense would go with Wilcox. And the big fella's been running. He just didn't get the finish that time.
15-18 to play in the ball game. Watch the basket.
And he's strong. So strength-wise, I'm not sure that he will ever be at a disadvantage. And here he goes right there. That was just a simple re-screen. It forces Camp to step aside for maybe half a step. And he dives right down the middle.
He ties the game at 49. And with the foul, it goes to the free throw line. A chance to put Long Beach in front for the second time tonight.
That's a great play coming out of the timeout.
Jennings is only a 41% free throw shooter. What is it with bigs at the line? Spend more time in the gym. Stop thinking so much. Just shoot them.
Hey, that's great. You know, sometimes it's hard to gauge a shot. It's a tough task for bigs.
Yeah, you get the weight room, you get stronger. It moves down to block. Bang it. It's going to hurt you on your touch. Look at Washington, just a mess outside.
Yeah, it just doesn't look like they know what they're in.
He's playing catch. Meantime, the shot clock is running inside the 10. Andrews now, stuffed by Jennings, who just measured him. They wasted 15 seconds out.
And to be fair, you see some teams that will just use time just to try to lull the defense asleep, but that wasn't the case in that last situation. You saw Andrews kind of barking at some teammates, trying to get them into whatever they're supposed to be in, but now you only have 7 seconds to get a shot.
And that'll be Wilcox from 23. 3 feet. Short. Jennings now is getting more aggressive. Caffey comes out on the run. He's going right to the back again by one. Spinning inside. Shows some quick reflexes. It was Jennings.
They were maybe 5 of 14 in the first half. Just got too far behind against a really good Creighton team. I think Doug McDermott is arguably the best player in the country. Look at that position.
Jennings again, 18 for him. So Jennings and Caffey, each with 18 for the Beach.
He's catching the basketball in the restricted area under the rim. 9 times out of 10, that's a bucket.
Wow, a goal. That was an assist for Caffey. So he ties his career high with 9. Steal by Jennings to Caffey. Gully. Back it out. Yeah, of course, Jennings wanted it, but he didn't get it. You can hear him now. He puts the target up and just pads the stats. The old Barkley missed the easy one, get it back, and a rebound in the bucket. Andrews kicks to Wilcox, check his feet. He wants 3. In and out. Look at Jennings come down. The elbows up.
Offensively, you can't get a much better look than that. That's a great drive from Andrews to suck the whole defense in.
Jennings, every time he rolls away from Cal football, you see the end of that Auburn-Alabama game that gets you set for the Territorial Cup. Put the remote down. Put your feet up. Under 5 minutes to play. See how Long Beach State plays with the lead on the road. Spencer's been a nice compliment to Caffey in that backcourt. Caffey double team, still had it. Had to get rid of it. There was still 5 seconds left. He just threw up a Hail Mary. Jennings went after. Look at Jennings. That's going to be goaltending on Jennings as he comes crashing down on the back of Mike Anderson. They do keep the possession. Refresh the shot clock. And Romar. Romar's all the way down at the end of the court. He's barking at the officials. Andrews and Jennings come together. A whistle, play on. They have 10.
Great point. That's what helps you win. When you're not defending the way you want to. You're not shooting quite the way you want to. Take care of the ball.
Take it away. A buck and a half to go. Long State down 3.
And they don't need a 3 right now. There's plenty of time on the clock again. They can go for 2.
Run that pick and roll with Jennings for quite some time. Caffey gets it bounced. Didn't get it. Sanders got pushed. Jennings came up with it. He's fouled.
Time Jennings able to finally come up with one of those offensive rebounds. There's been a few possessions where he's been down there fighting but hasn't been able to come up with it.
How about this? Jennings and Caffey have combined for 48 points, but combined at the line, they're 0 for 7.
You said it. Games within 5 points or so comes down to the free throw line, and that's the way it's shaping up here.
And he made it.
He's going Shaq on us. What is it? I make it when it counts. I make it when it counts in the third overtime.
Washington has outscored Long Beach by 17 points at the free throw line.
Long Beach State just 4-6, but they have played a national menu of opponents so far.
Interesting. Anderson starting on James Ennis. I thought maybe Muhammad would start on him.
And Dan Jennings makes the first power move in the lane and gets Long Beach on the board.
Well, he's coming on for them. The transfer from West Virginia had 20 against Ohio State on that last road trip. And the assist numbers show that he's getting people the ball where they want it.
Now there's the play we saw, Drew, right there. That's the move he made to win a game here against Irvine a month ago. Ball fake right, drive left.
Like the extra pass from Adam.
Great point about Larry Drew on the offensive end of the floor. How about here on the defensive end?
Well, I think it was kind of team-wide. It wasn't just one guy. It wasn't just one thing. It was just all the way around as Jennings knocks down another one.
And 4 starters, including a very good guard, Casper Ware, graduated off last year's team. Nice drive and dish Boy, Guffey with a well-done dish at the end. Caffey to Jennings.
About the no-look drop-off. I thought he was going to kick that out. Hating defenses, if you're doing it the right way on offense at the NBA level, the extra pass is at corner three as Jennings continues to get loose in the painted area. But you're
nice feed inside, and Jennings puts it down. So Jennings with 10 points in this first half.
He's just too deep. I mean, he's been deep this entire first half, and UCLA's got to do their work early and get him out of that deep post position. Haven't
yes, they?
They
have. Adam Strong and then Ennis looking to move. Nice bounce on the left wing, and Jennings finishes.
Exactly what Long Beach State needed, a stop. Transition, continue the momentum that you created by knocking down that big three at the end of the first half. And Ennis shielding himself from Ware and drops it off to Jennings. That's a nice play. Great execution by Long Beach in transition.
Jennings, a New Yorker from Staten Island, went to West Virginia.
Coming in, only averaging 5 points a game. He's got seven already. 18 to 19 footer.
Well, there's your point again, Don. You were right on that in the first half. That's a great entry, but Jennings was posting up 3 feet from the basket.
Kyle Anderson isn't strong enough to keep Jennings out of the paint. I mean, if he's got a foot in the paint, you might as well just foul him on the catch so he can't do that. Get an and one on you. But that's what happens when you switch ball screens and handoffs. You get mismatches. Anderson's got the length to deal with Jennings, but not the strength as a true freshman.
There's the spot and Deng. Well, there's Jennings forcing his way in, and Jennings continues to have his big night, 19 points.
Yeah, they've had no answer for him tonight. When he gets it down low, they haven't been able to force him out. Great contest by Travis Ware, but Jennings right there just goes right up through David Ware for the finish.
The big question for Long Beach here is to keep Jennings on the floor. Again, he's the only player in the game. Well, actually, James Ennis now has 3 fouls also, so...
You know what, though, Ted? Probably deep enough into this one where he's playing the rest of the way.
Yeah.
And if he fouls out, he fouls out.
Good shovel there and setting up Travis Ware.
Good shot. You'll live with it if you're UCLA. Just didn't go down.
And, oh, Jennings! Huge rebound.
Jennings following the play, the Caffey miss, nobody puts a body on him, and that's what you get. Big time two-handed dunk off the miss. Long Beach State right there.
And UCLA really going back to those key fouls on Ennis and Jennings of Long Beach and the defensive stop, the 35-second stop. It's now a 15-5 run, and there Jennings takes the nice dump down from Papa George. 21 for UCLA.
And there's some decent bigs in the league this year that if you don't, you know, put bodies on them, Moreland at Oregon State,
Kazemi,
Njai at Washington.
Well, you got a couple 7'2 brothers.
Yeah, the Baczynskis. Cal Poly beats him in here. Yep. So this team is obviously better than it was when it started the year. Still some things to clean up, still some things to work on. But I think it's trending in the right direction, especially on the defensive end. Really improved this time of year. You play Saturday, and as I mentioned, don't play again after that till the following Friday. I know Christmas is in there, but...
The hand pressure of this zone is terrific. You talk about length of the zone. You talk about a 6'5 and a 6'6 guard with almost 6'8 reach. They do a great job of getting over screens.
Jennings in the post, muscles one up, and gets it to go.
Nice job, Jennings sealing, catching, facing, ripping, and attacking off the bounce. great job again of Michael Carter. They do such a great job of getting over those screens.
Caffey, nice give up in the lane, and Jennings able to finish.
They worked out now to shoot around, getting through gaps, penetrating through the gap so they can draw the next defender and make a play.
There's the lob. That's not broken up. A fine, though, by Jennings. With the left hand, he can't finish. And he goes down hard. A foul called. And we'll step aside. Approaching the midway point of the first half. DeJuan Coleman called for the foul. And Long Beach State trying to hang in at Syracuse.
The days of Jim Boeheim paying seven guys. This is a nine-man rotation.
Fair across the lane. Rejected by Jennings.
Jennings is a big physical body. He does a really nice job offensively in the low block, and he's been active right now. Look at Michael Carter-Williams, his ability to probe the defense.
That was about as pretty a missed finger roll as you're ever going to see. And he knows he had a chance for a highlight bucket.
Again, they're back into the pressure, extending the defense. What they're really trying to do right now is speed up Long Beach State. Get them to attack in transition, get the game going a little bit more up and down.
Pretty nice spin move, though, by Dan Jennings.
Dan Jennings, terrific footwork, great hands, really good on that left block. As we watch the game, watch how more effective he is on the left block.
Ennis gives it up. Jennings fouled hard.
Jeremy Grant does not keep the ball on the sideline, does not keep the ball in front. I would suspect that Jim Boeheim, if you notice that, there will be a sub shortly. He's got to keep that ball in to give the second defender a chance to get that trap.
Good hard basketball play here, or would you have called this a flagrant foul?
No, that's a good play on the basketball. That's not a flagrant one. I think, he reaches in. He tries to make a play on the basketball. I think that's a good play. Veteran officiating crew right here.
Juan Coleman comes back on along with Sutherland as Trish goes back to the bench, as does CJ Fair. So James Sutherland, the sixth man for Syracuse, leads them in scoring. And last year, the sixth man for Syracuse, the sixth man of the year in the Big East, Dion Waiters, ends up as the number four pick in the NBA draft.
Syracuse opening up with two consecutive threes.
Nice running hook, though, by Dan Jennings. And he draws the foul and has a chance for an old-fashioned three-point play. DeJuan Coleman called for the foul.
Dan Jennings, again, on the left block. He's most effective on that left block. He's patient. He gets his shoulders into the defender and finishes with a nice jumper.
Out of high school, on our ESPN 100, Dan Jennings was the 16th-ranked center in the country. Sat out last year after transferring from West Virginia.
Let's see the adjustment Jim Boeheim makes for guarding the ball in the corner. But Dan Munson doing a really nice job. First two possessions, isolating the ball on the block. Again, stretching the defense out in the corner. And they have a good angle to feed the post against the zone.
And a left-handed finish by Jennings. Michael Carter-Williams, he averages 9.5 a game. Number one in the country. It's a pretty nice assist possible there for Caffey. The no-look sets up Jennings. He misses it first and then gets blocked by Christmas. Against a top five opponent, and you beat number one Kansas back in 1993. But overall, did you schedule that ambitiously?
Not this ambitiously, because we thought at that time the league was more than a one bid league. You're talking about UNLV, New Mexico State. They're going to need Coleman to finish around the basket, collect himself, and be a little bit more explosive getting to the front of the rim.
Grant tried to stuff it, and he was stuffed. Instead, here comes Papa George the other way. Gets a return, tries a three. That's off the heel, all the way out to Dang. Man, this is a brutal team to play against. I hate going against Paul Johnson triple option. And then you wonder why other teams don't do it. So why don't other teams play the 2-3 zone?
I think coaches are creatures of habit. It's really hard to get a coach to change. If you're a man-to-man coach, and you go 2-3 zone and you try to teach it, your players are going to know whether you're committed to it or not.
Tony hits a three.
The first time you give up a room and rhythm shot, in the back of your mind, you're thinking, it is something not good. And it's hard to commit to it. Now, again, Jim recruits to it. He's committed to it. The players buy into it. And that's why it's so effective. Besides, a guy in the back line right now, Grant's 6'10 reach. Bakita has got a 7'5 reach, and Coleman's got a 7'2 reach.
Jennings able to finish with the reverse, though.
Developing a Michael Carter Williams, you know, Coleman's going to continue to get better. You've got Bakita, who's really active in the middle of that zone. Jeremy Grant is a star in the making. So the future is no different than the past. You know, they're going to win 20 games, and they're going to be in the discussion for a national championship. That's just who they are right now. And, you know, for Long Beach State, this is a learning process. I mean, they've got to leave here. They're going to drive to Buffalo. They're going to fly to Columbus. And now they've got to play a very good Ohio State team. But this is part of Dan Munson's plan. He understands what he's getting into. And they're going to be better for this come league play.
Well, the education will continue for Long Beach State. They still have games coming on the horizon. From here, they go to Ohio State. So they'll just keep it rolling. Keita keeps it alive on the offensive glass. Carter Williams has it. Tries a no-look to Coleman, but it's taken away by Papa George.
And that's the one area Jim would like to see him cut down on. He's averaging almost 4 turnovers a game. And he's made good decisions today. That was the one time he tried to make something out of nothing.
Keita called for the foul. It's an NBA double dip tomorrow on ESPN at 7. The Celtics kick off the doubleheader against the 76ers. And then at 9:30, it's Lakers-Thunder. That's a pretty good nightcap. Both games available live on Watch ESPN. NBA Friday presented by State Farm begins tomorrow night. Celtics-Sixers at 7 Eastern. So Jennings at the free throw line. Again, Long Beach State's next stop, Ohio State. They still have a game at UCLA to come and toss in games against USC, North Carolina, Arizona, and Syracuse, all in your first 11 games.
Two seasons, they have won 2 conference championships during the season, won a conference tournament last year, competed really well. We're 24-9. So he's built something, but now he has to start all over again, and it starts at the point guard position.
Every year he's been there, the wins have gone up 6, 15, 17, 22, and 25 a year ago. But this will be a task this year to go above that 25 win mark, as Jennings going to work against Ravenel, got to the basket, has his own rebound, puts it back up, and it's good.
And that's one of the areas we talked about, offensive rebound. With Ohio State getting their best players to come to Ohio, says a lot about not only him, but the coaching staff.
Rebound off the miss. Jennings will push it up the floor, tied at 4, 16 minutes remaining in this first half.
Goals involved, you have to stay injury free, but
matchups are big.
Matchups, and you throw the wins out the window.
Nice drive and dish, and then a foul is called inside by Amir Williams. Yeah, as Jennings went up for the shot.
Yeah, and I make the point that when it comes to tournament time, here's Amir Williams right here. I think Amir reminds me a lot more of a shot blocker, rebounder, Ken Johnson type player that played here at Ohio State. Offensively, he's going to continue to get better. The coaching staff is working with Amir on his balance, okay, inside, not standing straight up, his strength inside. But he can be a game changer by blocking shots and being a force in the middle.
How much offense do they need out of him this year? Do they need him to score a lot?
Well, not only him, but you have to be able to score in the paint. Mm-hmm. Because what that does is sinks the defense. It makes you pay attention. Now that opens up, one, jump shots, but also driving lanes, because you can't help off a post player who's effective as much when you have that kind of ability in the post.
5.5 remaining in this first half. Stay tuned at the half for the State Farm Halftime Report. Dave Revson, Tim Doyle, and Scooney Penn all waiting in the studio.
My man Scooney, his first studio appearance.
They're going to give him a hazing.
Oh, yeah, they should.
Thomas, the 3, no good. The rebound inside, pulled down by Dan Jennings. Ennis back out to Papa George. Long Beach still looking for their first points of this second half. It's a 12-0 run stretching to the last half for Ohio State. Inside, Jennings going to work. Can't get the first. Can he get the second? He can, to the foul.
Well, excellent initial defense by Amir. Hands straight up on that second effort is when the hands came down a little bit. That caused the foul. Again, another teaching and learning point for the big man inside, that you're long enough.
Keep those hands up, body parallel. Now you have a chance to offset the shot.
Yeah, those are lessons that you learn in December that you hope pay off January, February, and in certain programs like this one, March.
Well, that's the beauty about the non-conference. You play against, you know, it was unbelievable, the ability for him to shoot the ball with range.
Ohio State, Jim, in the midst of a 17-2 run, really keeping the pressure on Long Beach State as they're struggling to score. Inside is Jennings. Nice little move against McDonald, who was there. Jennings able to pick it up, put it in just as the horn goes off.
When you want to win, and you want to win big, you have to have a certain kind of determination not to let teams win, okay? Some kind of desire and hunger and meanness that, yeah, we may be up 30, but you know what? We should go up 4, okay? And that's not a slap at your opponent, but that's more so what you're trying to accomplish as a team and what kind of message you're trying to send to other teams that may be scouting that you're going to eventually have to play.
Kraft just 2 for 5 today. Hasn't had a lot of attempts. Got into that early foul trouble and really limited his opportunities offensively. Now just looking to distribute with this big lead.
Well, what you want from Aaron Kraft is to be able to first, as you see Ennis creating going to the basket, is run the team. Defensively, you cause havoc. Offensively, you get players in positions where they can be successful. Then the shot is there for you. You become a threat. And Aaron understands, so there are going to be games where Aaron takes a lot of shots. And there are going to be some games where maybe only maybe have 5 shots, but it's the assist, it's the defense, and more importantly, it's the leadership that he brings to the table that makes him so valuable.
3 of his teammates in double figures. Villavalli with the shot, no good. Rebound inside, knocked around and controlled by Long Beach. Dang Dang with the rebound. And up the floor to Gully for 3. Way off the mark. Good rebound by Jennings inside, and Jennings takes it back up. Now there's a guy that's going to give them some good play when they get into conference, Dan Jennings.
Well, look at the bottom. He's built like a tight end.
He is.
But he's aggressive. He plays hard. He's in position.
Ennis up the floor and a one-handed stuff from Dan Jennings. That's impressive for the big man.
No, I like running the floor.